I've long enjoyed what you have to share. And in my mind, I struggle sometimes with some of the things that I hear. One of the places that I've been experiencing that lately, you addressed something about earth changes or your situation earlier. I realize the question I'm asking is not the real question.
They hardly ever are. But with enough listening, you always can get there. In other words, we can always hear the real question if you're patient enough.
The two circumstances that are somehow linked is that in a world of, or in a universe of infinite energy and infinite abundance, in this physical dimension, with all the information that I've taken in about geology, how the earth was formed and such, there's this stuff that we're using called fossil fuel. And I'm choosing this one in particular, I think, because somehow I relate to it differently than what you say about health, you know. And does my choosing health deprive another of wellness? No, of course not. Does my choosing wealth deprive another of wellness? Of course not.
And does your choosing fossil fuel deprive another of fossil fuel? Of course not. Uh-oh. You don't agree? You don't agree that this planet has the resources to provide all intentions that are identified, and that anyone who's in vibrational alignment with their desire will be able to have it? You think that this is a limited time-space reality and that you must be resourceful of your resources?
I feel as though I must get stuck there sometimes, or the illusion of stuckness. I'm beginning to see stuckness differently.
Think about the word resource. What does it mean?
To resource, to reconnect with source.
So, don't you think it is a very good word that has been assigned to resources? In other words, they are sources that keep becoming. They continue to become. That's why you call them resources rather than limited quantities. They are resources because they keep resurfacing, they keep being rediscovered, they keep remaking themselves. So let's say that in your environment that you had decided that the resources that exist in one small corner of the world is the bottom of the pile of that resource. So you would use up that pile and there would be no more for you. But someone who says, surely there's another pile somewhere, would find the pile. And what we are wanting to say to you is that there will always be another pile. That if this time-space reality has the resources to stimulate desire within you, it has the ability to back up the desire with manifestation. So while your fuel may change, or your utilization of it may evolve, as it always has, there will always be fuel for all things that you desire. It must be. Sometimes people say, well, Abraham, if everybody selfishly pleases themselves, then from my point of view, no one would ever go to work. And we say, well, but your point of view forgets all of those that are eager and fulfilled in their work. And then they say, really, Abraham, if nobody ever wanted to be the one that does such and such, then what would happen? If everybody followed your idea and everybody did what they want, then won't there be a whole lot of things that we need done that nobody's willing to do? And we say, if you have things that you need done and nobody's willing to do them, then you'll find another way of approaching it, because the universe always gives you what you want. In other words, there would be a different way of approaching it. Sounds like it's off the subject of resources, but it really is not. It's the same thing. Your fossil fuels have hardly been discovered. And as you undoubtedly know, they are the result of past civilizations. And since there are many future civilizations, then there must continue to be many past civilizations from those future places. It may bother you when you think about being somebody's future fossil fuel, but you will be. There's some long-range planning going on.
maybe that lays to rest the sort of the corollary question, which was about, at least the way I frame it, about, say, the carrying capacity of Mother Earth and the population issues.
That the core issue is not even about that. We think that that's a peripheral issue that sort of speaks to the core issue, but we think your core issue is about shortage in and of itself. The feeling that there is a quantifiable amount of something that you don't have access to. All shortage is personal and self-imposed. All shortage. Shortage of clarity, shortage of dollars, shortage of abundance, it's all self-imposed. But we understand how people would come around to not believing that or not wanting to believe that, because it does feel better to blame someone else initially, unless it steps on the toes of your own freedom. But when you have the choice of saying it's somebody else's fault and therefore they're powerful, or I get credit for it and therefore I'm powerful, we think you'll take the empowering thought every time, you see. And we think that you can consciously and intellectually and knowingly explain and mean it, that shortage is an illusion, except on a few topics. And we think you've heard enough here today to move easily through those. In other words, when you think about the subject of shortage, is fossil fuel really the subject you want to talk about? Or is that just your way of justifying the notion of shortage? The sort of like Esther saying, it is right that I feel the way I feel because they did bugger up my water heater. And so I think I'll just beat the drum of this. And Jerry is saying, oh, please don't beat that drum anymore. They could destroy the whole coach in the week that we are here. In other words, please, let's find another way of approaching it, you see. Have you been looking somewhere where there seems to be not enough love? In other words, are you a sensitive being looking into the corners of the world and seeing injustice, or is it more personal?
It's more personal. When I look out there, it feels like I'm distracting myself from the core, which is somehow...
So how is it showing up in your experience? You know how when you have a sore spot and you feel around and you can actually then feel the sorest of the sore spot? So feel around and see where that feeling of shortage is. How is it showing up in your experience? Do you think it's lack of control? Do you think it's lack of justice? Do you think it's lack of universal love? Do you think it's lack of the Creator's good intentions?
What's coming to me right now is the dance between what I'll call humility and arrogance to, in fact, be the empowered, gifted being I
good.
Am.
Those are perfect words. That's exactly where it is for you. In fact, when you sat in the chair, we started to count your ears because we can feel the power with which you have come forth intending to be of value. And this is the standard that you keep holding yourself to. You are a teacher to the very core of your being, and you want to make a difference, and you want to be of value. And we have to say to you, we've been light about Esther's feeling of frustration at the motor coach place, but we have to say, when someone like you or someone like Esther, who knows who you really are, in any moment is not being it, you take it pretty hard. And so we think that's the shortage that you're talking about. You're beating up on yourself for not living up to the standards of your own personal fulfillment that you've intended. And this entire seminar has been for you because we're really wanting you to feel that it doesn't matter where you are, your idea of who you are is still there. And where you are in relationship to where you want to be now is easily achievable. Now you know what to do, you see. So as you find yourself stepping into a thought such as, here I am this many years old and what do I have to show for it in terms of, you can feel which way you're going, in other words, on your way back to Phoenix. And so, and then you reach for some other thoughts and you're going to feel marked movement in your vibration as you implement what you've been hearing here today. We think you've heard it and we can feel you are extremely articulate and the words that you speak are remarkably in alignment with the vibration that you feel. In other words, you are as in touch with your feelings as anyone that we have ever beheld. And therefore, this process of moving up this vibrational scale is going to be easy for you. And the sort of hell that you've been living, and that's much too strong a word, is because when you have this sensitivity and you don't know what to do about it, it just drives you crazy. But when you have this sensitivity and you know what it means and you now do know what to do with it, Yes, indeed.